Okay, so as I was telling you, today we start the learning experience number four. Okay, so welcome to the class and welcome to the learning experience number four. And what is the purpose of this class? Okay, somebody is coming. Okay, yeah, what is the purpose of this class, guys? What is it? Actually, today we have, of course, the introduction of this topic, of this new learning experience. Tenemos la introducción de esta experiencia de aprendizaje que la vamos a hacer. De hecho, está dividida en cinco actividades. Five activities. It means, ¿no? Significa que la vamos a trabajar por 5 semanas. Okay, so, what is the purpose of it, of this activity? ¿Cuál es el propósito de esta actividad? It's basically, we're going to read some texts. Vamos a leer algunos textos. And we have to get the specific information. Yes, we have to be able to do it. And also, we are going to, okay, catch the vocabulary, no, el vocabulario and everything. Yes, so, and let's pay attention. And please, I will ask you, les voy a pedir, por favor, que incrementen su vocabulario, ¿no? Que ustedes mismos por sí solos busquen información, ¿okay? For example, Renzo does something very nice. He sends us, ¿no? Sí, él siempre nos envía páginas, por ejemplo, que nos pueden ayudar. So that is great. Do it. If you have internet, you can do it, ¿okay? Bien, so my dear students, let's get started. And this is the title of the learning experience number four. It says people. People who make a difference. Okay, so we're gonna talk about people, some important people who make a difference. I think people who do interesting actions, yes, so they are different, okay? Bien, so guys, do you have any doubts maybe? Did you understand the title? ¿Entienden el título? Do you understand it? Is there any word? ¿Hay alguna palabra que quizá no entiendan? So, because we have to have it clear. Tenemos que tenerlo muy claro. A ver, what is the meaning of people? ¿Cuál es el significado de la palabra people?
Gente.
Very good. Yes.
Personas.
Ajá, personas, gente. Yes. Actually, en singular decimos person, ¿verdad? Person. Pero en plural es people. Resulta que algunos singulares son irregulares, algunos sustantivos, sorry, nouns, son irregulares, de manera que se escribe en singular de una manera y en plural de otra manera, ¿no? Entonces es el caso, por ejemplo, de person, y yo no puedo decir two persons, three persons, for example. No, no existe. Entonces tengo que decir people. One person, two people, three people, four people, for example, okay? Yes. Okay, and it says people who, gente que, ¿no? O quienes make a difference, ¿no? Que hacen una diferencia. Ya está. So, we always have, when we start a topic, cuando iniciamos un tema, una experiencia de aprendizaje nueva, siempre vamos a tener este recuadro. This chart. No sé si se acuerdan, chicos, pero este recuadro mismo lo vamos a tener también al final, cuando hagamos la actividad número 5. Five. ¿Okay? Entonces, es básicamente para saber nosotros, para reflexionar o tener una idea de cuánto sabemos, cuánto conocemos antes de realizar este tema. Y al final será pues para no evaluar cuánto hemos aprendido. ¿Okay? Entonces, no varía en nada el hecho que ustedes marquen yes, no. No tiene nada que ver con la nota que les vaya a poner. Simplemente es para reflexionar. ¿Okay? Entonces, acá vamos a tener más o menos una idea de lo que vamos a hacer el último día o en la actividad número 5. It says, for example, al escribir un texto para una infografía o un fanzine en inglés, adapto, ¿no? ¿Qué adapto? El texto. Adapto para escribir, para describir a un peruano o una peruana y las acciones que realiza en beneficio de su comunidad. Entonces, más o menos van haciéndose la idea de qué es lo que van a hacer al final. Entonces, si ahora mismo yo les digo, chicos, a ver, escríbanme un texto, ¿no? En donde ustedes describan a una persona peruana que realiza acciones, ¿no? En beneficio de su comunidad. A ver, yo sé que muchos de ustedes sí lo pueden hacer, pero a ver, ¿no? Quizá algunos no, pero bueno, ahí está. Ustedes marcarían yes, I can do it and very well, si lo puedo hacer muy bien, or simply yes, or yes, but I need help, or no, okay? So, there's no problem, no hay problema, okay? Igual, por aquí también nos vamos a ir dando cuenta más o menos qué se va a evaluar. Organizo mis ideas para describir a una persona. Uso el conector AND, lo que habíamos utilizado en la semana pasada, remember? The vocabulary, el vocabulario, sentences, oraciones sencillas. We are going to use the present continuous, presente continuo, ¿ok? Bien, por ahí, por ejemplo, miren, acá tenemos present continuous. Ustedes pueden ir por ahí revisando en Google, en YouTube. Present continuous, what is the present continuous? How do I use it? ¿Cómo lo utilizo? So you're going to have more knowledge about it, okay? What else? Reviso un texto en inglés. Reviso si el texto en inglés describe las acciones que una persona no es básicamente para revisar si no cuando ya elaboro mi texto, soy capaz de hacer eso. So that is something that we have to do before doing the activities, okay? Antes de hacer estas actividades, antes de hacer incluso la actividad 1, okay? So that is it. And here we have the general challenge. Tenemos acá el reto general y es lo que se nos va a presentar también en la actividad 5. Ustedes ya más o menos o ya saben la secuencia, cuál es el proceso de cómo vamos desarrollando las experiencias de aprendizaje, okay? So my dear students, as I tell you, here we have it. It says la celebración peruanos del bicentenario. Ustedes saben que este año es nuestro bicentenario. Convoca a jóvenes de tu edad a presentar a un peruano cuyas acciones benefician a su comunidad, ¿ok? What's your challenge? Dice, describe las acciones que esta peruana o peruano está realizando en beneficio de su comunidad o país en inglés en un fancy una infografía, ¿ok? Entonces ahí vamos a tener activities. Son 5 actividades, pero las actividades 1, 2, 3 and 4 are gonna help you. Te van a ayudar a qué? A prepararte para hacer finalmente tu challenge. Okay, so that is something that we have to do. And here we begin. Acá iniciamos. This is the activity number 1. And the name of the activity number 1 is landmarks. Yes, landmarks. Don't forget that. So, my dear students, tell me, do you have any idea of what landmarks means? A ver, ¿quién sabe? What is the meaning of landmarks? ¿Cuál es el significado of landmarks?
Guessing that land means countries, and marks like milestones or flags. So putting those words together, I could say that both could mean like flags of countries.
Countries, flags. Okay, yeah, very good, Ren. So that is a good observation. Look at that. Si no sabemos exactamente el significado de una palabra, también podemos, miren, acá tenemos, generalmente hay muchos compound words, ¿no? Palabras compuestas en inglés, al igual que en castellano, y están como que uniendo más o menos, ¿no? Land es, sí, tiene que ver con tierra, ¿no? Superficie, por ejemplo, ¿no? Marks, ok, ya más o menos nos hacemos la idea de qué puede significar, ¿no? Ok, yeah, very good. Okay, so landmarks is basically points of reference, son puntos de referencia. In this case, I would talk about patrimonios, ¿no? For example, here in Peru, our famous, the most famous landmark is Machu Picchu, for example, here in Peru. Yes, in every country has... every country have landmarks. Yes, so we're gonna talk about that. So we're gonna talk about the countries. Vamos a hablar de los países, the flags, las banderas, the landmarks and the cities, las ciudades. And also we're gonna talk about the languages they speak. Languages, yeah, idiomas, the languages that they speak. So here we're gonna complete this paragraph. Vamos a completar este párrafo, estos párrafos. We have some paragraphs. With the information we have here, and it says French, English, Spanish, Aymara, Portuguese, Mandarin, Chinese. Again, let's repeat everyone. Yes, todos repitan. No es necesario que enciendan los micrófonos, pero repitan. Yeah, It's French, English, Spanish, Aymara, Portuguese, Mandarin, Chinese. Okay? So, tell me, what are they, guys? Are they countries? ¿Serán países estos? Tell me. Do you think they are countries? ¿Creen que son
Idioma.
países? Ah, yes, they are languages. Yes, languages. Yes. Okay, and so we are going to use those words, we're going to use those languages, vamos a utilizar esos idiomas para completar los espacios acá. Renzo, could you please read the first one?
What about the first? His name is Yakis. He's from France and he speaks French. An example.
Thank you, Renzo. Yeah, this is an example. Okay, es un ejemplo. And here we see this guy, this boy with his flag. And here we have a tower. Do you know the name of this tower? ¿Saben el nombre de esa torre? Nothing. A ver, this is a famous one, eh? But anyway, okay. Here we have it, and here, for example, we complete with the language French because he's in France, Paris. Yes? Yes, that. His name is Jack is, I think, right, Renzo? And he's from France and he speaks French. And I want you to pay attention to this. Prestamos atención acá. He speaks. The normal verb, el verbo correcto normal, the base one, ¿no? La forma básica es speak. Speak without S. But in this case, this is an affirmative sentence. Es una oración afirmativa. Estamos hablando de la tercera persona. He, ¿no? Él. Entonces, digo, he speaks, ¿no? For example, I speak Spanish, ¿no? I speak Spanish, but he speaks French. He speaks Spanish, for example, okay? So don't forget that. Very good. How about the number? This was the example. And the number one, Araceli, could you please read the number one?
Her name is Isabel. She is from Peru and she speaks Spanish and no sé, Miss.
Another Peruvian language. Choose another Peruvian language. Otro idioma peruano. Another.
Quechua.
From the list, acá, de la lista, Aracelita, acá. A ver, which one is another Peruvian language? ¿Cuál de estos otros idiomas es otro idioma peruano? A ver, which one?
Aymara.
Aymara, yes. So yeah, because Aymara is only spoken here in Peru, so yeah, we guess that she speaks Spanish in Aymara. Thank you, Araceli. Very good. Good job. Very good. Number two. Number two is gonna read. It's gonna be written by Sharon. Could you read number two? Sharon Pacaya.
Miss,
Can you read? ¿Puedes leer el número dos, please? You can do it, Sharon. Lo puedes hacer. We help you. Te ayudamos. Yes? Okay. One, two, three. This one, acá. Con la bandera brasileña. That one.
Brasil,
Yes.
yeah, Miss. My name is Marcos. He is from Brazil. Speak.
He speaks. Tomamos uno de arriba. What is the language of Brazil? French, English, Spanish, Aymara, Portuguese, or Mandarin Chinese?
Portuguese.
Portuguese. Very good, Sharon. Very good. Thank you very much. The next one, number three, is gonna be read by A ver, Alfredo, could you read it, please?
Yes, teacher. Her name is Mei Shi. She is from China, and she speaks Mandarin Chinese.
Thank you. Yes, very good. Yeah, aha. The last one, please. Cristina, could you read the last one? Number four. Okay.
Profe, disculpe.
Yes,
sí,
yes.
Sí, se pronuncia así, Chinese, el idioma, Mandarin
Chinese. Chinese. Yes. Aha. Thank you. Very good. Yes. Awesome. Aha. Okay. We listen to you, Cristina. The last one. 1, 2, 3.
His name is Oliver. He is from England. He speaks English.
Oh, very good. Thank you. Yes, that. Very good, guys. Good job. So, yeah, here we have number one, Isabel, and she's from Peru. Look at the information here. Miren la información que tenemos acá. Her name. And it says, acá en el ejemplo dice, his name. So, what's the difference between using his and her? A ver, ¿cuál será la diferencia de his y her? Porque acá dice, miss, pero acá dice his name y acá dice her name. What is the difference? A ver, ¿quién nos puede explicar? A ver, ¿quién sabe la diferencia de his name and her name?
Profe, la diferencia específica no lo sé, pero se puede deducir que es porque uno se refiere a que soy hombre y otra mujer.
Yes. Very good. Claps. Aplausos para su compañero. Muy bien. Esa es la diferencia. Miren que no es necesario saber exactamente y pues traducir todo lo que vemos, sino que las imágenes nos ayudan. Miren, look at the pictures and it helps us. The pictures help us a lot. So, his is for men, for a male, ¿no? Para masculino. His, su, ¿no? Su es el posesivo de él. His name, her, el posesivo de ella, her, ¿no? Her name. Y por ejemplo, cuando digo mi nombre, yo digo my name, ¿no? Por ahí podemos repasar los possessives, por ejemplo, ¿okay? So that's gonna help us a lot. Bien. And ya tenemos ahí. Muy bien, that's it. Yeah, here, his name is Marco. He's from Brazil. Ayer los estudiantes del primer grado, por ejemplo, me preguntaban, ¿no? Miss, pero Brasil se escribe con S, ¿no? Yeah, that is in Spanish, but in English it's Brazil, ¿no? Entonces, miren por ahí, ¿no? Those details, and that is the pronunciation, Brazil, okay? Here we have, yes, May, and she's from China, yes, very good. Okay, so, yeah, there we have it. I would like you to practice a little bit. Me gustaría que ustedes practiquen también. A ver, por ejemplo, Alfredo Ramírez, where are you from? Alfredo, hello, where are you from? Are you from Peru? Are you from China?
Venezuela.
You're from Venezuela. Okay. And Sharon, where are you from, Sharon?
Peru, miss.
Peru, okay. Alfredo, I would like you to introduce us your friend Sharon. A ver, utilizando la misma estructura de los pequeños textos que hemos leído, preséntanos a tu compañera Sharon. A ver, we already know where she is from. Y luego Sharon nos va a presentar a Alfredo, okay? So that is what we're going to do, lo que vamos a hacer. A ver, Alfredo, could you do it? ¿Podemos hacerlo, Alfredo?
Yes.
Yes, that's
Debo
great.
Debo presentar a Sharon.
Ajá. Así, utilizando la misma estructura que hemos visto en los textos. Simplemente cambia la información por su nombre and everything related to Sharon, okay? 1, 2, 3.
Debo presentarme a mí o a Sharon.
No, no, vas a presentar a Sharon, o sea, ¿cómo dirías? His name o her name, por ejemplo.
Her name is Sharon. She is Peru and she speaks Spanish.
Ajá, yeah, thank you, Alfredo. Solo te faltó por ahí, she's from Peru. She's from Peru, ella es de, ¿no? She's from Peru. Very good, but very good, Alfredo. Nice. Sharon, now it's your turn. Tu turno, Sharon.
His name is Alfredo. I'm from Venezuela.
The last sentence, la última oración. He speaks. Venezuelan. No, Spanish. Yes, very good. Thank you, my dear students. Very good. Awesome. So there we have it. You see? Now, one couple more. Una pareja más. A ver, I would like it to be... A ver, volunteers, voluntarios. Are there volunteers?
Araceli.
Yes, Araceli. Are you ready?
Está bien.
Okay, Araceli and another one. ¿Alguien más, chicos? Cristina, could you?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, we listen to you guys. I guess you know each other. Yo creo que se conocen, saben de dónde son. Así que, a ver, vamos a escucharlos. Anyway. A ver, one, two. Ah, primero empezamos. Araceli, you introduce Cristina, and then Cristina introduces Araceli, okay? So, one, two, three. Araceli, you start.
Sí, pero no entendí muy bien.
Siguiendo el formato de acá, siguiendo el formato de estos pequeños textos que hemos visto, tú vas a presentar a tu compañerita, ¿ya? A Cristina, ¿ok? Entonces, ¿cómo dirías his name? ¿Cómo iniciarías? ¿His name o her name? Her name.
Está bien. Entonces, ya. Her name is Cristina. She is from Peru and she speaks Spanish.
Thank you. No te olvides, Aracelita, como hablamos de ella, he, she, tercera persona, tenemos que agregarle la S al verbo, ¿no? En este caso es speaks. She speaks
Spanish. Gracias.
Thank you very much. Ahora, Cristina, you introduce Araceli, please.
Her name is Araceli. She is from Peru and she speaks Spanish.
Great. Awesome. Very good, guys. Very good. Now, okay. So we are done with this activity and let's continue. This is the second activity. And here we have what I told you. Acá tenemos los textos que les indiqué. Yes. Miren, ahí está. Ok, a ver, por aquí alguien nos está. Ok, so here we have the texts. We're gonna read them, vamos a leerlos. And we have to get all the information, yeah? We have to get the specific information. Tenemos que sacar la información específica de los textos, ok? Y está, a ver, let's see. Well... But we have them. Ahí los tenemos. We're going to listen to them. Ya los vamos a escuchar. I'm gonna play the audio. And please let's pay attention. And let's take notes of pronunciation, okay? One, two, three.
Experience 4. English. Level A2. People who make a difference. Activity 1. Landmarks. Let's listen and read. Listen to and read the blog entries of teen bloggers from different parts of the world.
About me.
Hi everyone, my name is Pierre. I am 17 years old and I live in Paris, France. I am bilingual. I speak French and I speak English too. I am studying German in school. My favorite landmark in my country is the Eiffel Tower. Everybody takes a picture of it when they come to Paris. It's really cool.
About me. Hola, my name is Diana. I'm Peruvian. I'm 16 years old and I am trilingual. I speak Aymara with my grandparents. I speak Spanish with my brothers and sister. And I speak English too. I am studying English at my school. A famous landmark in Peru is definitely Machu Picchu. It's amazing.
About me. Hi there. My name is Jack. I'm 15 years old, and I live in Alaska in the United States. I only speak English, but I am studying Spanish in school. My favorite landmark in Alaska is Mount Denali. It is a huge mountain in the United States. I love it when it's full of snow. It's beautiful.
About me. Ni hao. My name is Lin. I am 17 years old. I live in Beijing, China. I am bilingual. I speak Mandarin Chinese with my family, and I am studying English at school. The Great Wall of China is definitely a famous Chinese landmark. Many people come to see it. It's awesome. Now do the exercises in Understand Exercise 1 and 2.
Great. We have it. We've listened to it. Yes, y hemos escuchado. Did you understand, guys? ¿Han entendido algo de los textos? Have you?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, very good, guys. Yeah, because you already speak English. You are awesome students. Yeah, so here, for example, we have Pierre, but I would like you to see the structure. Now, what information they have here? Yes, what information they give? ¿Qué información nos dan? For example, we have a greeting. No tenemos el saludo. Hi, everyone. Hi, everybody. Yes, for example. My name is Pierre. So here we have the introduction. Name. My name is. I can say my name is, or I can say, for example, I am. Right? No problem. And also the age, like that. I am 16 years old, and I live. The origin, el origen, o donde vive. No, I live in Paris, France. I'm bilingual, ¿no? Soy bilingüe, y ustedes también pueden decir eso, yeah, I'm bilingual, because you speak English. I speak French, and I speak English too. Miren acá, too, también. I'm studying German in school, miren, está estudiando también alemán. And my favorite landmark in my country is the Eiffel Tower. Yes, everybody takes a picture of it when they come to Paris. It's really cool. And here, he's describing, está describiendo the landmark, just a little bit, un poquito sobre, un poco mencionando algo de su landmark favorito. Y acá nos da una opinión. It's really cool, ¿no? Es fantástica, ¿no? Chévere. Okay, there we have it. Now, here the same, la misma estructura. Hello, hola, because she's Peruvian, okay? My name is Diana, I'm Peruvian. Miren acá, ya no está utilizando el country, el país. Simplemente está diciendo, I'm Peruvian, la nacionalidad. Peru, Peruvian, por ejemplo, eso también podrían estudiar, ¿no? Peru, Peruvian. Argentina, Argentinian. Venezuela, Venezuelan, por ejemplo, okay? The United States, American. Yes, for example. Mm-hmm. The age as well, no, like that. I am 16 years old and I am trilingual. I speak Aymara with my grandparents and I speak Spanish with my brothers and sister. And I speak English too. Mm-hmm. Ya está, por ahí nos dan una información extra. I'm studying English at my school. A famous landmark in Peru is definitely Machu Picchu. It's amazing. Miren, ahí yo siempre les digo, amazing. This is the word. It's amazing. Es sorprendente. Okay? Good. The same here. Hider. Hola. Hider. Es un poquito más informal este saludo, pero it's okay. My name is Jack. I'm 15 years old. I live in Alaska in the United States. The United States. Cuando estudiamos inglés, sufrimos un poco para pronunciar este país, ¿no? The United States of America. I only speak English, but I'm studying Spanish in school. My favorite landmark in Alaska is Mount Denali. It is a huge mountain. Dice que es una montaña enorme in the United States. I love it when it's full of snow. It's beautiful. Ya ahí tenemos la... el adjetivo beautiful. Next. He's Chinese, or she's Chinese, and says, Ni hao, my name is Lin, I'm 17 years old. I live in Beijing, China, and I am bilingual. I speak Mandarin Chinese with my family, and I'm studying English at a school. The Great Wall of China is definitely a famous Chinese landmark. Many people come to see it. It is awesome. Yeah, there we have it, guys. So here we have the reading comprehension activity. Tenemos una actividad de, oh bueno, we have more activities of reading comprehension. So what do we have to do here? It says let's understand exercise number one, complete the chart. Yes, so vamos a completar acá este recuadro. So, I hope you have all the information. Creo que ya lo tienen toda la información en su cabecita, chicos. I hope so. Eso espero. I don't know. And you have to tell me here, yeah? We have the information. What are we going to get? The country. I mean, country, país, age, the language they speak, yeah? And the landmark. Okay. So here, for example, we have Diana. She's from Peru. How old is she, guys? How old is she? How old is Diana? Do you remember it? What is her age?
Yeah, she has 16.
Yeah, she's 16 years old. Okay, thank you, Renzo. Yeah, she's 16. And how about the language? What language does she speak? Language or languages? Because it could be one or two or three or I don't know. There are multilingual people.
Trilingual.
Aymara. Very good. But you have to mention all the languages that she speaks. Aymara, coma. What else?
Spanish.
Uh-huh. And... no more? Oh, let's check. Maybe she speaks more languages. Diana. She says, I'm Peruvian, 16. Yes, very well. Trilingual. She's trilingual, guys. She speaks Aymara, she speaks Spanish, and she speaks English, too. Very good. Yes, awesome. Very good. And English, yeah? No olviden de siempre utilizar los connectors, ¿no? Los conectores acá. English and English, yeah. Last one, okay, yes, example, and the yeah, her favorite landmark is Machu Picchu. How about Pierre? Where is he from? Do you remember? France. Sorry,
France.
He's from France, yes, France. And tell me, oh, yeah, he's 17 years old, and what languages that he speaks? Do you remember the languages that he speaks?
French,
yes, of course. Yeah, French.
English.
Mm-hmm. And is there any other language?
Yes, he studied in German at school.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Actually, he doesn't speak French yet, but he's studying it, yes. I think, well, let's say in German, okay. Thank you, Renzo. Yes, that we have it. Okay, now how about the landmark? What is his favorite landmark? Do you remember it? What's his favorite landmark?
Paris?
No, landmark, Paris is the city, es la ciudad, but what is the landmark? Landmark vendría a ser el atractivo turístico, el patrimonio, something like that, ¿no? Algo atractivo en su país. What is it?
Eiffel Tower.
This is, Tower. Yes, the Eiffel Tower. So, that is something that we have to write. I'm not sure if I can copy this. Okay, the Eiffel Tower. So that is something that we have to complete here. Yes, I did it. Okay, now, Jack. How about Jack? Do you remember about Jack? Where is he from? In English? The United States. The United States. Actually, we can say we're gonna write it complete of America. Yeah, that is it. Oh, the USA. We can also say that USA. Yes, the United States of America. Oh my God. Yeah. H. How old is he?
15 years old.
Sorry. 15, okay, 15 years old. He speaks English. Yeah, he says, I only speak English, solamente hablo inglés, but he's studying another language, yes? How about
Spanish?
Oh, yes, yeah, he's studying Spanish. Está estudiando castellano, ¿no? Yeah, pretty good. Now, how about Ling? She's from China, she's 17 years old, and what languages does she speak?
Mandarin Chinese.
Mandarin Chinese, and just that? Is she a bilingual, multilingual, trilingual?
Remember? English school.
Let's see. She speaks Mandarin Chinese with her family, and she's studying English at school. Yeah. She's a bilingual. So you complete here, Mandarin Chinese and English, yes? And what is her favorite landmark? Do you remember? The Great Wall, no? In Spanish we say La Muralla China, the Great Wall. That's it. Okay, so once we do it, una vez que hagamos eso, we have here a matching activity. Vamos a relacionar. Here we have their pictures, tenemos sus imágenes, sus fotos. And here we have the sentences, yeah? We have sentences that we have to match. So, for example, he loves snow, an activity that he loves. Okay, he loves snow. Yeah, ama la nieve. Yes. And the other one says he speaks two languages and he is studying another one. He speaks two languages and he is studying another one. Está estudiando otra, dice. Next. She's almost 18 years old. She's almost. La palabra almost significa casi. Ella casi tiene. She's almost 18 years old. Number 3. He's starting to study a new language. Está iniciando a estudiar otro idioma. Nuevo idioma. He speaks different languages with different members of her family. Estudia diferente. Habla diferentes idiomas con diferentes miembros de su familia. Okay, so tell me. So, in this case, we can draw lines, podemos hacer líneas, pero también podemos poner acá la letra que corresponde, okay? So, el número, the number, I mean. For example, tell me, letter A, Which number? ¿Con qué número iría la letra A? Tell me. A ver. What I think. Creo que no tenemos la información todavía muy específica, muy clara. I will give you some time. Les voy a dar un poquito de tiempo para que vuelvan a leer. Read the texts. Lean los textos. Get information. You have 1 minute. Okay, guys, are you ready? ¿Listos ya? Ready?
Yes, teacher.
Great, thank you. Now tell me, letter A with number...
One.
Number one, okay. Good. Letter B? Nothing. Letter C.
Miss, letter B goes with number 4.
Number 4. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Letter B for he is starting to study a new language. Letter B. Before. Okay. I know. Before. This one. She speaks different languages with different members of her family. Yes. Mm-hmm. How about letter C?
Two.
Two. And how about... that's the last. It's already done. Yeah, let's see. Let's check if that is correct.
No, means falta. Él tiene dos. El último.
Oh, yeah, yes. Mm-hmm. So, what is it? Yeah, one was missing. The last one would be. ¿Cuál es la última para este joven?
Number
3. Number 3. He is starting to study a new language. Yes, this is the one from. Is it for him? ¿Para quién sería esto? He is starting to study a new language. Is it okay? For letter D?
Sí.
Mm-hmm.
Sí.
Yes, a ver, vamos a ver acá. I'm studying Spanish skill. Yeah, okay. So, my guys, my dear students, you have to check your answers. Tienen que revisar sus respuestas. Anyway. Mm-hmm. Yes, have to check your answers, okay? Yes, Diana speaks, for example, she speaks Aymara with her grandparents, but when she talks to her siblings, she speaks Spanish, for example, no? And she also speaks English. That's nice. Okay. Yeah, pretty good. Mm-hmm. Great. Solamente que acá me falta poner un recuadrito para poner acá la, el número, okay? The number, because he has two. That is it. Okay, my dear students. There we finish the activity number one, and we have to evaluate our knowledge, what we have learned or what has helped us or something like that. Puedo comprender detalles específicos en un texto breve en inglés. So, can you do it? ¿Pueden hacerlo? Was it easy for you to do it? ¿Fue fácil or not? You have to tick. Ya tienen que seleccionar, bueno, lo correcto. Yes or no. ¿Puedo comprender hechos básicos en un texto simple en inglés? Okay, so the same, my dear students. That is everything we're going to do this class. No es todo lo que hacemos, tenemos que hacer en esta clase, pero siempre tenemos que incrementar nuestro vocabulario, la información. For example, here we have countries, nationalities as well, landmarks, and for example, the we have also the present simple, presente simple también, no? For example, we have used that for affirmative sentences, third person, no, la tercera persona, and also some adjectives, adjetivos, no? For example, amazing, beautiful, awesome, yes, those. That is very important, my dear students. Okay.